Ideally, find a group of people who will hold you to your goals. You want a group who will question you if you aren't giving your all, but will also be supportive during tough times. Are there any groups or networks you could join? Find what works for you, and be sure to turn up every single day. Redefining failure. To succeed, you first need to fail many times. I am not guaranteeing your success by following my methodology, in fact, quite the opposite. I encourage you to fail often and hard. The problem is that when we see the word fail, we associate it with negativity. In this section, I redefine what failure is and encourage you to seek it out. As we grow up and become more aware of ourselves, we try to avoid failure at all costs. It is something that is generally frowned upon. In fact, we go out of our way to hide failures, embarrassed to let people see our mistakes. This is an exceptionally short-sighted attitude. It is only through failure that you learn from mistakes and make improvements. In his bestseller, Black Box Thinking: The Surprising Truth About Success, Matthew Syed discusses the different approaches to failure in various industries. In particular, he looks at the difference between the aviation and healthcare industries. The aviation industry is incredibly open when there is a fatal crash. Investigations begin immediately. All avenues are explored and recommendations for safety improvements are made. In contrast, the healthcare service, due to its culture and targets, has tended to cover up mistakes. It means that countless opportunities to learn can be lost, which may lead to further incidents that could have been avoided. Unfortunately, the aviation industry is in the minority. Many industries are guilty of covering up or placing blame on an individual. Fortunately, I am involved in an industry where failures and defeats come thick and fast, often in the public eye. You will have seen many sporting events where pundits analyse every move in super slow motion. It is possible to examine performance microsecond by microsecond. The failures are out in the open for all to see, and most people tend to voice an opinion. I can assure you that the same thing is going on behind the scenes. After each race, indeed after most training sessions, there is some form of debrief. If mistakes are made, we want to know why. Was it simply human error? What could we do differently next time? Most athletes do this automatically after a race, match, or competition, whether they have won or not. How many athletes have you heard after achieving a personal best saying what they could have done better? I'm guilty of it too. I've heard it being described as being too hard on yourself.